Okay. If you're watching later, leave me a comment. I'm on the toilet because I'm... Same old stuff. We don't need to go over it again. But anyway, I didn't do a live earlier. I'm not doing great right now. And I was like, oh, I should go live. So here I am. And looking for, you know, all of you lovely people out there who are struggling and who are desperate to find peace. You're not alone. Hi, everybody. Hi, Mags. You're up early. What time is it? Why are you up this early? Hi. I missed you too, Riley. So I'm totally on the toilet right now, which I don't think I've done on YouTube before. I've done it plenty of times on Instagram, but not YouTube. So welcome. This might be the live toilet debut of my, where it's live in the century of the my being. I feel like shit. How about you, Laura? No, I'm good. I'm just doing my best, and it's been a rough night, and I'll say that. And I don't know why it's such a comfort for me to go live when I'm struggling, but I'm just so grateful for you guys. But I'm okay. I'll be fine. It's just kind of a rough day. That's all. No, I'm not going number two. That I've never done. That I've never done, nor will I ever do. So, I mean, I have standards, guys. Only peeing on camera. And only burping. I won't fart on camera either. So it's like, I'm fine peeing on camera, but I don't want to poop on camera. And I'm fine burping on camera, but I'm not okay with farting on camera. So, makes no sense, but whatever. Oh, I'm sorry, Ellie. What was your rough day? Tell me about your rough day. Paint. I'm a painter. I just posted a couple new ones to Instagram. You should go check them out. One of them is so weird, but it kind of reminds me of like an Asian type style of painting. It's actually really cool. I love it. Danny loves it. Paul loves it. We're probably going to be selling it, so go check it out. And then I also posted another one tonight where I used a new technique that I haven't done before, and the painting ended up really cool with like so many cells. So go check those out. And if you're interested in buying, you can bid on eBay, or you can buy it straight up for a higher price, but you could, you know, I don't know. Yeah. So just type in Educating Shanny on eBay and you'll see my paintings. Meh, it was just school and my mental health, but it's all cool. I'm having a drink at the moment, so oh, okay. You couldn't sleep with me? That's okay. Did I ask you to sleep with me? The things people say sometimes, I'm just like, are you just real bored? What's going on in your life, bro? I'm sorry, Holly. Yeah, Riley, well. Yeah. Hang in there, okay? Hang in there, keep doing what you're doing. You're doing it. As long as you're doing the best you can, then it will work out. So I don't know how long I'll stay. I don't know how long I'll stay. So ask me questions if you want, or I don't know. Or we could talk about you guys. That's wonderful, Ellie. Good for you. That's really, really freaking amazing, and I am beyond proud of you. Yeah, I'm doing real well with my eating disorder, and I can't believe that I've made it this long without binging and purging. Crazy. I think I'm at 45 days now, 46. I'm hoping to, I'm really hoping to make it to 50 days at least, because I want to make a video how I got to 50 days, you know what I mean? You're doing good, Riley. Don't give up. Sorry, Holly. That's annoying. Why are you drinking and smoking, Ellie? Well, you've been blackout drunk because you're drunk to your black. Wait, you blacked out your drunkenness, so it helps you coast. Oh, cope. Sorry, honey. Are you an alcoholic? No judgment here if you are, by the way. This is a judge-free zone. But I get that. Like, my eating disorder helps me cope. Like, I get it. You don't consider. Okay. You're the only one that knows you. But either way, I'm proud of you and keep fighting, okay? Try and give up that stuff. I'd rather you give up on that stuff than give up on your life. Mighty says, I'm a bit afraid of going on a one-week holiday with my boyfriend and some other friends. I don't know if I can stay clean from binging and purging, but I hope that I will stay strong. Are you implying that you're clean right now? Because you said, I don't know if I can stay clean. Does that mean you're clean right now? I find the hardest part is like the first 2 or 3 days is the hardest part. And then it starts to become not quite a habit, but a little bit more of easier, I guess. And then it becomes a habit, and then it becomes a craving to not do it. I can't, you know what I mean? Hi, Charmaine. I'm glad you're happy. Yay. You couldn't sleep either. Welcome. Is that what you meant when you said you can't sleep with me? Legit. Why it's been a bad night for me, but that's okay. That's life and everything will be fine. I'm sorry, punk rock. It's hard. Like, I'm looking forward to making this video and explaining like what helped me and what I did to go for so long. And by the way, can I say that it's starting to become, actually, it's full blown, not my norm anymore. They say it takes 21 days to make a habit or break a habit, but that did not do anything. 21 days did not break it. Like, I was still craving it every day. It didn't feel, what was I just talking about? Wow, my brain just completely stopped. Shocking. I need to get my brain fixed or checked, I mean. I'm dead serious. I have like memory issues. Does anyone know what I was saying? I'm a week self-harm free and I'm proud. I've gone a year, but especially in my situation, I'm so proud of myself. I'm proud of you too. That's amazing. That is amazing. Hold on 1 second. Oh, Mighty, I was talking to you, about staying strong. Did you say, let's see. When I'm alone, it's hard and I can stop for like a weekend And it's exactly like you described it. Right now I'm not doing good. It's really like a craving. Do you have any advice to overcome the craving? So like my biggest advice to you, and this is going to sound so obvious, but it's like maybe hearing it out loud will help you. Focus on the weekend. Focus on being with all those fun people. And when you eat dinner, just be conscious of it, as far as like, just listen to your body. That's what I do a lot. If I'm nervous about going to like a dinner where I know there's gonna be tons of food and stuff, then I kind of prepare myself mentally, and then wow. Guys, I'm not okay. What is happening? Am I having a stroke? Like, why am I forgetting everything mid-sentence? What were we talking about? Oh my gosh. This is actually... I'm sure you wouldn't wish to sleep with me. Well, I'm married, so... I'm sure someone would love to sleep with you, though. I'm joking. Don't know what I was saying, but, do you have any advice on overcoming the cravings? What was I saying? Oh, getting out of your own head is really important. And also, like focusing on other people. Oh, that's what I was going to say. When you're eating, I have to, in those situations where I know it's like a big feast, I have to listen to my body, and I have to remind myself to listen to my body. And it's a big, big process for me. Like this is so, such a weird angle, but at least I have a blanket so you don't have to see my bits. But just listen to your body. Listen and eat it slow, eat slow, and stop when you're satisfied, before you get too full, because that's, in my experience, the biggest trigger for purging is feeling full. So don't let yourself get full. Just pay attention to your body and your hunger cues, and eat until you're satisfied. But mentally, just focus on having fun. Focus on other people. Get out of your own head. It's not worth, you know, all this torment. Like, you deserve to go and have fun, so do that. You can do it. I believe in you. Yeah, I'm always extremely pale. I am severely anemic, so love that for me. Hey, Steph. Ellie, how old are you? You must be talking about college, not high school. Unless maybe you are. I don't know. See, I don't know when people start drinking, because I don't drink. I don't get how it works. Like, I know there's a legal age, but I feel like people drink. Like, teenagers drink. How do they do that? I don't know. I don't know how anything works. Stephanie! You're my best of me. You make me happy. And I love you. That's your song. You're welcome. Talk to my blood doctor. Oh, I have. Don't you worry. yep. I'm going to doing everything I can. Are you new around here? Legit rock star. Who are you? Welcome. You're welcome, Steph. Anytime. Stephanie makes me feel happy. And she's a beauty with a heart of gold. There you go. That one's better than the first one. Um, we are all special. And oh, okay. Okay, Steph. I had the thought while I was singing to ask. I should have asked because my sister Angela is the same way. She doesn't like to be called Angie. It drives her insane. It's either got to be Ange or Angela. She can't do Angie. So when I was like singing halfway through, I was like, maybe I should ask her because why have I never seen her full name? You know what I mean? Like the other Steph in our community that's pretty active, she's got like one of hers is Steph, a different one is Stephanie. So it's like, but yours is always Steph. So I should have known. Good to know though. You're 19. Okay. Is the acoustic good in the bathroom? Yeah. Well, I don't know. You tell me. I think so. I made some singing videos in this house where I sing in a different bathroom, and it's really, really good acoustics. Probably not stuff, but I let you know about that. Okay, well, have you ever heard of Botox against depression? No, I've heard it against like migraines, but is this a thing? People get Botox for depression? Like, is that a physical or a mental thing? Thanks, Erin. You can make me cry a little. She said, Shanny, just want you to know my heart goes out to you in regards to your last couple videos. I'm proud of you for holding your ground and learning to do what you need to keep yourself well. Thank you, Erin. That means more than you know. Thank you. Okay, Steph. Gotcha. Oh, my device broke. I wish you could see what I'm doing, but you can't. It's really funny, though. It's pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. Stay. There we go. Nice. With Holly. I feel guilty for being sad about my life. My twin never got a chance. Do you mean that you feel guilty if you're happy? Because electroconvulsive conclusive therapy? I would try it. Why not? Aw, Ellie. I love you, girl. I'm proud of you. We have a pretty awesome community, don't we? We really, really do. And I know it's been rough lately, but I'm happy that I've kind of extended the InstaFam over to this platform now because we can just keep welcoming more and more and more people that are out there and struggling and need somebody just to say, I understand. And to hear how other people got through those trials. Like, it's just so cool. So I hope those of you that are interested will help me with this and help me to, I've already started, but just help me get it back to where it was because I need help. I can't do it alone. I need encouragement, and I need patience, and then I need you to like go leave comments in this live stream after it's over of like stuff you would want to see from me that would help, and yeah, I'm working on it though. I feel like she should have been in my place. Maybe people would prefer her. Well, that's just simply not true, Holly, at all. That's just not, that's bullshit. That is your inner voices lying to you and making you feel terrible. And I don't know, I don't want to like cross the line here, but I guarantee you that your twin is wherever she is in heaven, but also with you and being like, girl, you got to live. I didn't. So you need to live for me. Like, she didn't get the chance to have a life, but you do. So do it in honor of her, and don't spend your time feeling guilty about something that you didn't do wrong, she didn't do wrong, your mother didn't do wrong. It's just what happened, and it sucks that that happens. But look at this as an opportunity to give her the life that she never had. Let her live through you, and let that keep motivating you. Thanks, Charmaine. I know, you're so sweet. You guys are being so sweet. Well, I mean, not that that's odd, but I feel like we're getting there. Yeah, she's right with you. She has your back. And she doesn't want you, yeah, to be guilty. She doesn't want you to be treating yourself this way. Because it wasn't her fault. It wasn't your fault. It wasn't anybody's fault. It just was what happened. Thank you, Shanny, and everyone else. I promise these are happy tears. Okay, good. Good, good, good. That's great, Holly. We all believe in you. Do it for her. Did she have a name? If she doesn't have a name, maybe you could name her. And because I find like having a name, like for me, I'm back. Sorry, my phone died. Hopefully people will come back. I wonder if it will notify them to come back. Probably not. Yay. Sorry, my phone died. I'm the worst at keeping my phone charged. It drives Danny insane. Thank you, Holly. You too, guys. You're just... don't even see how awesome you are sometimes. Which is a shame, because... you're amazing. Well, I love pistachios. I've never heard that, Aaron. I don't even know what that is. Where'd you go? I miss you so. Seems like it's been forever since you've been gone. Since you've been gone! Wait. Is that the song? I don't know. Y'all, I'm gonna go make me some breakfast, because it's almost breakfast time. Make me some hash browns and some eggs. That's what I'm gonna do. And onions, of course. Can you come out to us? Of course. Was that your way of doing that? That's wonderful, honey. Congratulations. Is that what you meant? I don't know what you mean. You can trust us and we will cheer you on and love you no matter what. I hate not being out to my family, but now you're my family, guys. So I'm trans. I'm a guy. That's awesome. So you were born a guy? I don't know the wording for that. So were you born a boy? I mean, in a boy's body? Or were you born... Oh, you were born female. Okay. So you don't even... So do you even have a name for... Or do you just want it to be Holly also? And is that why? Like, because you haven't told anybody? I feel very honored that you trust us enough to tell us that, because that is such a big moment in your life to come out to anybody. And that's kind of how it happened with me too, was Alicia and I were talking, and I don't know what we were talking about, but I was like venting a little and saying the hard things that I was going through, and it just came out. I was like, oh, and also I'm gay. And I was like, I'm not gay, I'm bi. Like, I corrected myself, but I don't know why. Like, I didn't plan it to happen. It just kind of came out with her, and that's how it was supposed to be, you know? So just follow your gut on... Come on, what? What are you talking about, Riley? Are you mad at me? What is happening? Anyway, not one person in the community made fun of me or acted disappointed or anything. And so I'm proud of you for coming out to us. I'm guessing Holly's typing. Yeah, we're really proud of you. Riley, are you mad at me? I can't tell. When you said, come on, Shanny, what do you mean by that? Riley, tell me, now I'm worried. Sorry if I worded something wrong. It's just my way, I guess. Is Amy live too? Oh, my video freezing. Oh, okay. That makes sense. Okay, cool. Okay, I was like, did I say something offensive? Probably, but I never mean to. Hold on, I gotta turn my heater off. It's like bloody hot in here. Well, Holly, would you like us to call you Holly? Tell us more. You kind of just disappeared on us. What's happening? But yeah, that's huge, and it's so hard when your family, you know, who are supposed to love you no matter what, it's hard. Like, I have an amazing family. I really lucked out. There were a couple family members of mine that didn't take it well, but they still love me, and they still support me no matter what. So I like that you said, you know, your family's not supporting you, so you're leaning on our family. Because that's okay. Like, there are different ways to have a family. A family, to me, is unconditional love and support, and just selflessness out of pure love. And always being there for you.
when we can.
Riley, girl, boy, sorry. Riley, her, him, nope, there. What would I call you? How about I just call you Riley? Don't hurt yourself. Not worth it. Hey, Star, how are you? I've seen you forever. If you're the same person I'm thinking of. Pal? I like that. Okay. Hey, pal. What's up? Muffin. I call everyone Muffin. I'll call you Muffin. And keep reminding me, Riley, because I had forgotten until you said that. I completely forgot. So keep reminding me. Hopefully it'll get to a point where I can remember who is what and what I say offensive and stuff, which obviously you guys know I never mean to do. So I'm just, I know Muffin is cute, huh? I call everyone I love Muffin lately. I don't know why. I just think it's so cute. My little Muffin. You're sick. I'm sorry. Aw. Thanks, Megan. You're awesome. Seriously. And I want your hair still. I need to save room for my breakfast, for my eggs. Sorry, Riley. I really am. Yeah. Okay. I'm going to take like maybe one or two more questions and I'm going to go get some. Hopefully, if you pray, please pray that I'll sleep because I'm starting to get delusional. I've been crying all night and it's been a really hard night, both mentally and physically. So if you have any extra prayers, good thoughts or whatever, that I can fall asleep because I need this day to be over and start fresh tomorrow, or today technically. But yeah, send in if you have a question or anything, and if nobody sends in questions, then I'll probably go. It sounds like I'm threatening you, like, if you don't post questions, I'm gonna leave. You missed what? Nobody knows stuff I didn't explain further. So I'm trying to be positive and I'm trying to, not fall into victimhood, which, because I don't want it to escalate. Does that make sense? Yeah. No, you didn't miss anything I just said. I don't know what I said, but I was very vague about it. I didn't really talk about details, but it's okay. Really okay. Everything will be okay. Just gotta stay strong. Thanks, Holly. I appreciate that. Riley, all these inspirational quotes, girl, boy. Oh my gosh, I keep doing it. Buddy, pal. It's never gonna end, but I'm going to try. You don't have to always be positive, hun. If it builds up, it could go worse. Yeah. I mean, yeah. That's true. I don't know. a weird position that I'm in, and I'm just been trying to figure out the best way to do what I do. I don't know. Thanks, Erin. You too. Kiddo, that's cute too. Okay, I think I'm gonna go. You mean like talk about it and then delete it? What have we talked about so far? Because I might want to save it. What do we talk about? Like, do we talk about things that would be super helpful to people? I don't know. But I'm tired anyway, so I should probably just go to bed. But maybe tomorrow I'll try and talk a little bit more about it. I'm totally fine. There's nothing to worry about. I just had a really bad night, really rough night, and that happens a lot, and that's okay. But I'm trying to learn to not let that consume me and not let it define me. So I know it's hard for me to figure out what's healthy, though. Like, I also gotta think about that, like, what's healthy. And you're right, holding it in will make me explode. But I have to take in, like, every consideration: the community, my family, my husband, myself, my health, my mental health, being the quote-unquote leader of the mental health community, not the mental health, my mental health community. There's just a lot of factors that go into it, so it's not that easy. So, I'll probably talk more about it tomorrow when I'm not so tired. If you start a new one, then delete. It's nighttime there, right? Most are asleep. It's actually 6:30 in the morning, and I've not slept all night, so, but maybe I'll do that tomorrow, or today, or whatever time-wise. Maybe I'll do that. I don't know. We'll see. Because I'm also, still under pretty strict orders, to not stress out myself too much, so I've already been crying all night, and, I have a feeling that's why my stomach is hurting, so I don't want to make it worse right now, but maybe tomorrow or later on after I rest, then maybe I'll feel a little better and we can talk about it more. Or we just won't, because to be honest, it's nothing you haven't heard before. Just a lot of frustrating things happening at once, and it builds up. And it's like once a month it does this. I'll have like a day or 2 days where every single health, physical health and mental health illness flares like crazy. And I have a lot of them. And it gets really frustrating. It makes me feel angry sometimes. Like, I get really short with Danny or with anybody. 'Cause I just am so miserable. But that's bound to happen, like, statistically, that's bound to happen, considering how many different physical and mental health problems I have. I'm sure everyone that has so many things go through this, where everything just flares up at once, and it's extremely frustrating and excruciating, and, I don't know the other words, because I'm tired. I'm not good at words. You know what I'm trying to say? Does everyone know what I'm trying to say? Because I don't think I know what I'm trying to say, but... Harley. Okay. Harley. I'll try and remember. Remind me again, okay? I like the name Harley. You could just change it to Harley. Yeah, Erin. Yeah. Yeah, it's like I can't is, and so it's like some, I'm finding that it's not relatable to you guys. And so what's the point of talking about it? Cause like a lot of you guys have a lot of the same things that I do, but not, it's so conceited, but like nobody knows what it's like to be in my position on the internet. So you got to factor in everything, mental, physical health, eating disorders, all of that. And then add on, being a face of a community full of thousands of people who are struggling themselves. Like, it's just a different dynamic for me. And so when I say that I want to try and stay positive, I just keep thinking about why I started this channel. And I didn't start it for drama. I started it with the intent to educate and warn people, and also take people through my recovery and encourage and love everyone out there. So I don't know. So it's just hard, you know, but that's okay. That's life. I know, I love the name Harley. That's a really good name. Shanny, I'm telling my care tonight that I'm trans and I know how to explain non-binary in my case. I just need to get it off my chest. In real life. Girl, get it? Bah! Pal? Babe? I can call you babe. I don't know. Just Riley. You go, non-binary, non-man or non-woman or binary. Or non-it of the kiddo. That's what I said. It's gonna take some time for me to get used to it. Don't give up on me and don't get offended, please. Muffin, my little muffin. It's relatable to you, Steph? Like, everything I'm going through is relatable. Except for the fact that, I don't mean this to sound like rude. I feel like it's rude to say this, but like none of you, I don't know how to word this kindly, but like none of you know what it's like, to be ahead of a whole community full of people that are struggling just like you are. I don't mean that to be mean or anything. I'm just trying to get my thoughts across of why I feel sort of alone. In that sense, but I'm working on it, and I've been working on it with Danny, and that has been so helpful, and Paul too. Paul has been so wonderful, and we've had so many middle of the night conversations on Marco Polo, and I don't know, he's like a brother to me, and he's been wonderful. And then of course Danny, who's always wonderful, has just been incredible. I feel so lucky to have people that care about me that much, and to have you guys that care about me too. But anyway, so it's something I'm working on behind the scenes and practicing some little things here and there. If you need water, hold on. Maybe Serena, maybe, I don't know. I know I have BPD, but for some reason I am terrified of it, and I don't know why. And so I've been avoiding learning about it, and I don't know why. I think I'm just, I don't know why. I can't even put my finger on why. but it very well could be. I don't know. I don't know much about it. All I know is I have it, and that it often gets misconstrued for, like, other things, like bipolar. People sometimes misunderstand it because it has the word personality disorder in it. Like, that's, I remember before I learned what it was, I remember thinking, oh, that means that, that's like schizophrenia. Like, you hear voices, talk to different people, borderline personality, you have different personalities, you're a different person. I don't know what I thought, but so I think I get afraid that people will think that of me too. But that's stupid. I should just talk about it more and learn about it more. Thanks, Steph. Yeah. Okay. Well, for real, this is the last question, then I'm gonna go. I'm eating fake, like the American cheese slices, except the white ones. I grew up on this cheap, disgusting crap, and I love it. All right. Send in your question, and I'll pick one to end on. That's a good one, Riley. How did you get the courage to share your story? Because I want to share mine when I'm older. You should. It's probably possibly at the very top of my list of scariest things that I've ever done. I'll never forget posting my first video and how terrified I felt and how I was literally, I was like, people are going to hate me. People are going to disown me. My family is going to be disappointed in me. I was terrified, but as we all know, I have a little bit of a, whatever you want to call it, psychic or sixth sense or in just like really deep intuition. You know, I dream when people die right before they die, and I always know when someone's pregnant before they know it, and then I always know the gender before they know it, like weird things like that. Forgot what I was gonna say, of course. Brain sucks, guys. Anyone know what I was saying? Thanks, Holly. Thanks, Harley. Yeah, Aaron, for sure. What matters to you today? What will make you smile a genuine smile? It's an interesting question. Oh, posting my first video. Thank you. Oh, I was talking about how I have this weird sixth sense or whatever you want to call it. And I distinctly remember, like, I don't know, 7 years ago, laying in bed, I remember looking at the towel that was covering my window because I always cover my windows. And I remember looking at my birds that used to be right in front of my bed so I could see them all the time. And I remember having the thought of, you're going to do something really special someday. Like, not a typical thing that most people would do in my world. Like, in my world, we get married and have babies and whatever. But I just remember having that thought and knowing that, and always hoping it, but deep down, I knew deep down that something cool was going to happen, and that I would somehow create a community for people to come together and be there for each other. And I think that is what 2 years after that, when I started, because I almost died and I had had enough, we back? What's happening? Can you guys see me? Interesting, Megan. I didn't know that. See, I need to, you can see me? Okay. I forget what I was talking about. No, I was saying that's what gave me the courage, was knowing ahead of time that something was going to happen. I didn't know what it was yet or how it would happen, but I'll never forget that feeling where I realized. And so that gave me the courage 2 years later after I almost died. I took that, and then it just felt right. It was like all of a sudden it almost knocked the wind out of me, and I called my brother and sister-in-law immediately because they're like tech savvy and would know a lot about social media and YouTube and stuff. So I called them first thing, like right away. And I was like, what if I did this? Like, what if I started a channel? And they're like, yeah, totally do. And I'm like, no, what if I started a channel of like to build a community and to try and help as many people out there as I can, and to also take them through my recovery and blah, blah, blah. And they just, both of them were so supportive, and they helped me with like logistics and stuff. And then Paul, first night I met Paul was when he came over to help me learn how to edit. And that was the first time I ever even met Paul. Even though he had been friends with Danny for 4 years before that. That's how much of a recluse I was. I had never met Paul before that, but he taught me, and then we did it, and it just was scary, and it was probably scary for the first 100 videos, to be honest. Maybe 50 videos. But it was so worth it, obviously, in the end. So, anyway, I'm glad I did it, and I'm sad that last year I let it go and didn't give it much care, but this is a new time, a new year, and I'm going to keep working on it, you know? So, okay, I'm going to go to bed. I think I'm falling asleep finally. Yay. Okay, thanks for hanging out. I'll see you, I'm sure, tomorrow. We'll see. I'm enjoying going live. Like, I was just going to, like, not do anything until my ulcers healed, but going live is really relaxing to me, so I'll probably still go live every day. We'll see. But yeah, anyway, so I'll talk to you tomorrow, and I love you all, and remember forever and always that you are beautiful, you are worth it, and I am too.